Hello YouTube, and welcome to this, the second video of my route learning series for Train Simulator 2015. Today we're on the Riviera line, and we'll be travelling from Paignton to Exeter in Devon, which is in the southwest of England. The Riviera line's actually 28 and a quarter miles long, and we'll be taking train 1 Alpha 87, which is the 1415 Paignton to London Paddington service, as far as Exeter. We'll be calling at Torquay, Newton Abbot, Teignmouth, Dawlish and Exeter St. David's. The traction for today will be an HST, also known as a high-speed train. Originally, when they were first brought out in the late 1970s and early 80s, they were known as the Intercity 125. The official name of the locomotive, there's one locomotive on each end of the train, is the Class 43. And these have been re-engined with an MTU 16V4000 engine. And the engines are rated at 2,250 horsepower each. So with two locos to a train, that's a total of 4,500 horsepower. The maximum speed of this train is 125 miles per hour, but we won't be going at that speed today, as the maximum speed on the route is 100 miles per hour. This train also achieved a record of 148 miles per hour, which is the world record for diesel trains. We've got a first Great Western 7-coach formation of one first class coach, one buffet coach, and five standard class coaches. The weight of the loco is 70 and a quarter tons. This is the cab of the Class 43 locomotive, and we'll just have a quick look around before we set off. Over here, we have the reversing handle, which has four settings: forward, neutral, reverse, and off, but off isn't simulated on this particular train in Train Simulator. Over here we have the throttle control, which has five steps. As the train is currently in neutral, we won't actually move anywhere. Then next to that on the right we have the AWS reset button, which is when the AWS warning goes off. And then to the right of that, we have the horn control, which only goes one way, unfortunately. Up here, we have on the right, the gauge on the right, which says amps times 100 is the ammeter. So we can see how much power is being generated by the electric motors, as this is a diesel-electric locomotive, which means the engine generates electricity to drive the train. Next to that on the left, we have the speedometer, which is pretty self-explanatory and measured in miles per hour, as all trains in the United Kingdom are. Over this side, we have the brake gauges. The main one to look at when driving is the middle brake gauge, which shows how hard the brakes have been applied. And then down below that, we have the brake handle, which is a 7-step brake. Step 1, which is the initial application. Step 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which is known as full service, or the hardest brake application you should normally make when in service. And beyond that, emergency, which should only ever be used in emergency and should never be used in normal service. So now we've been given the all clear to depart, we'll release the brakes and put the power into step 1 for a smooth and gentle start. The journey to Torquay is just over 2 miles. Now we've got a little bit of speed, we'll go into step 2 of power. And as we depart Paignton, we'll cross Paignton North Level Crossing, which you can see just in front of us. Please do bear in mind that the speed limit leaving Paignton is 20 miles per hour, so don't want to exceed that. And the maximum throttle setting we'll use to get to that speed is notch or step 4. We'll go into step 4 now, we've reached 10 miles per hour. And once we reach the 20 mile per hour speed limit, we'll shut off power to let the train coast for a short while. As you can see just here, we've got a speed board that says 30 over 40. The 30 mile per hour speed limit is actually for freight trains, and the 40 is for passenger trains. We've got to wait until the back of the train has passed the speed board before we can accelerate. We'll now give it one step of power, just to try and prevent us from using too much speed as we're going uphill slightly. And as we reach this house on the right, which is just behind a tree there, we can now be certain that the back of the train has passed the speed board. We can go into full power to accelerate to the 40 mile per hour speed limit. As we reach the 40 miles per hour speed limit, once the needle is pointing directly at the 40, we'll now shut off power, let the train coast for a few seconds, and then briefly we'll start going uphill. We'll need to give it one step of power, again to prevent the speed from falling too drastically. As you can see, the needle's now pointing below 40, so I'll give the train one step of power to try and maintain reasonable speed. Notice that the needle will slowly crawl back up to 40 miles per hour, and once we've reached that, we'll then shut off power again and let the train coast. Very shortly we'll be going downhill and we'll actually need to use the brakes to control the speed. So there's no point in having the throttle up at this present moment. As we round this next sharp right-hand curve by the sea here, this is where the downhill gradient starts. It's actually quite steep for a train at 1 in 57. So that means that the line falls 1 foot for every 57 foot we travel forward. So as we reach the end of the curve, we'll put the brakes into step 1 to ensure that the train doesn't break the 40 mile per hour speed limit. As we reach these buildings on the right, we'll see a little bridge here that we go over in between them, and at this point we'll now release the brakes because the train's levelled out. And when once we reach this last building on the right, we now know that we're half a mile from Torquay. There's no point in giving the train any more power now, so we'll just let it coast towards Torquay as we're braking in a few seconds for the station. As we round this left-hand curve, we'll see a bridge now just in front of us. Once we go at no faster than 35 miles per hour under this bridge, so just apply the brakes into step 1. You can now see the platform at Torquay, so we'll step the brakes up to step 4, which is around 3.5 on the brake gauge. As we travel through the platform, we'll gradually release the brakes to come to a smooth and controlled stop. The stopping point for HSTs is actually at the end of the platform. See, I've now stepped down to step 2 braking, and it looks like I'm going to stop slightly early. So again, I've released the brakes more to step 1. You can see the stop sign there where it says HST on it. So now we're clear to depart Torquay, we'll release the brakes and go into step 1 of power, again to give a smooth start. And as soon as the train just starts moving, we'll go straight up to step 2 to give an extra boost of power. Please do bear in mind that the speed limit is still 40 miles per hour leaving Torquay. Gradually we'll step up all the way to full power, as we're just about to be climbing a steep gradient. of 1 in 56 towards Tor, which is the next station along the line. We're not stopping here today, so we'll be going through that in a short while. As you can see, the gradient that we're now climbing is affecting our ability to accelerate, so we'll get to the speed limit quite a lot slower than usual. Here you'll see we're just about to cross three bridges in quick succession. As we get here, the speed limit will be around 40 miles per hour. So we'll step back three steps in power to ensure that we don't go over the speed limit. As we round the curve into Tor Station, the gradient will actually level off and we'll need to briefly idle for power. As you've just seen, we've just passed the 45 mile per hour speed limit board. So I'm now going to give us step 3 of power. So the back of the train passes pretty quickly at this speed, until we reach the 45 mile per hour speed limit. Now you can see the needle slowly crawling up towards 45. We're actually climbing again at 1 in 73 as we leave Tor. Down to step 1 of power, just to ensure that we don't break the speed limit. And along here we just need to adjust the speed limit as required to try and ensure we maintain as close to 45 miles per hour as possible. As you can see, the speed's just fallen off, so I'm now going back up to step 2. Speed slowly crawls back up to 45, I'm reducing power again. We will shortly be going downhill, won't require any power until we're almost at Newton Abbot. Now shut off power completely. As we round this curve, we see there's a 60 mile per hour speed limit, 30 over 60 there, and we're actually now going downhill at 1 in 110. I've had to apply one step of braking just to ensure we don't break the 45 speed limit. Back of the train has passed the speed board as we pass this little box on the right. Just past that, we'll now release the brake. We'll go into step 1 of power to gently accelerate towards the 60 mile per hour speed limit. As we're on a downhill gradient, as the speed gets just above 50, I now shut off power and let the train coast up to the 60 mile per hour speed limit. Once the speed is reading 60 on the speedometer, then I recommend you brake in a step 1 brake application down towards 55 miles per hour again. See, the needle is now reading 60 miles per hour, so I'll now apply step 1 of braking, like I said, to just knock off a bit of speed to ensure that we don't break the speed limit. as we're down to 55 miles per hour again, I'll release the brakes and the train coast back up. The gradient should level off before the train has the chance to coast up to 60 miles per hour again. Around this left-hand curve, just that bridge there, you can just see in the distance a speed board, and that's actually a 55 mile per hour speed limit, because we're already coasting. We're already at 55, so we don't need to do anything. We're now half a mile from the next speed reduction, which is to 40 miles per hour, and I recommend applying the brakes for this speed limit as we pass under this bridge, the first bridge on this four-track section. We've joined the main line on the left, which is the main line through Devon into Cornwall to Penzance. I'm now going to go up to step 3 braking to ensure that we don't break the speed limit. That beep sound that you just heard was actually the AWS. When you pass over a track magnet and the signal is not green, it's either yellow or red, then you'll get that sound, and you have to reset it within about 5 seconds. Or the brakes will go on. As we now enter this shallow right-hand curve on this three-track section, we now know that we're just half a mile from the platform at Newton Abbot. I recommend applying the brakes as we pass under this bridge. We'll go into a step 2 application to bring the speed off gently. And then up to step 3 to ensure that we're not entering the platform at faster than about 25 miles per hour. Now release the brakes again to step 2 so that we gradually coast into the station. Unfortunately, here at Newton Abbot, there is no sign to mark where the HST stop point is, so it's a bit of a guess. I'm going to aim to stop at the 8-car stop sign, which says VT on it, which will be for Virgin trains, to try and ensure that we stop in roughly the right position. Here you can see the VT8 coach stop sign. So now go into step 2 braking for a gentle stop right here. Now we're clear to leave Newton Abbot, so we'll release the brakes. Do bear in mind that the speed limit leaving Newton Abbot is still 40 miles per hour. now we're in full power, and we'll stay at that until we reach the 40 mile per hour speed limit, at which point we'll idle the power and coast until we're able to accelerate. So for a brief moment we'll be running on the wrong line, and then we'll cross a set of points onto the up line. So now I've reached 40 miles per hour and I've idled the power. As you see the speed board there, the 40 with the arrow pointing left. So in the UK, if you see a speed board with an arrow pointing in a certain direction, that indicates that the speed limit applies only to that direction. And we can apply full power to accelerate to the 60 mile per hour speed limit. Now we've passed that the back of the signal, which you just saw to the right of us. Again, once we reach 60 miles per hour, we'll idle the power to ensure that we don't break the speed limit. As you can just see here, we've got a 90 mile per hour speed board. Unfortunately, there's no exact reference to know when to accelerate with the back of the train, so it's just a rough guess. And I normally leave it until I can just see the end of this curve, which I can now. We'll now go up to full power to accelerate to the 90 mile per hour speed limit. And we should just about get to 90 before we have to slow down for the next speed limit, which is 80, and the one after it, which is pretty close to that, which is 60 miles per hour. As we leave the water on the right for a brief moment and we pass under this bridge, we now know that the 80 mile per hour speed reduction is 1 mile away. Now we've reached the 90 miles per hour speed limit. We've now cut the throttle to idle to coast. Now we enter this curve here, we apply step 2 braking, which should slow us down nicely for the 80 mile per hour restriction. And that was the AWS warning for a Morpeth board of 60 miles per hour, which is half a mile from the limit, so we'll leave the brakes in step 2. In fact, that should slow us down nicely for the 60 restriction. Now we've reached 60 miles per hour, we'll release the brakes and just let the train coast into Teignmouth, which I believe I've pronounced correctly, but if I haven't, then please do correct me in the comments. As we round this curve, you'll notice what appears to be a set of factories that we're just going past on the right. And as we pass the second set of factories, or warehouses, just now, with the wall starting on the left, we need to brake for Teignmouth. And we're going to go up to step 4 braking, and work our way down from there. The stopping point for an HST is actually right at the end of the platform. gears I slightly misjudged, so I've just added an extra step of braking to ensure that we don't overshoot the platform. And now we've stopped at Teignmouth. Now I've been given the right of way at Teignmouth. Release the brakes and apply power. Do bear in mind that the speed limit departing Teignmouth is 60 miles per hour, shortly rising to 75. So we round this left-hand curve leaving Teignmouth, we now come alongside the Dawlish seawall, which runs for, I believe it's 4 or 5 miles, alongside the railway. Now entering the 75 mile per hour speed restriction, however, the 75 board is actually only just under a mile from a reduction back to 60 miles per hour. So for a train accelerating out of Teignmouth, don't have time to accelerate above 60 before we've got to slow down again. So once we reach 60 miles per hour, I'm going to idle the throttle and leave the train to coast pretty much all the way to Dawlish. The AWS for the Morpeth board there for the 60 speed restriction, which is half a mile from the board itself. Now we're at 60, I'll idle the power. And we shouldn't slow down to below about 55 miles per hour between here and where we need to brake for Dawlish. Now entering the 60 mile per hour speed restriction. You can see just ahead a tunnel, which is actually the first of 5 consecutive tunnels through the hills here. As we leave the fourth tunnel here and enter the fifth tunnel, as we enter the fifth tunnel, it's actually half a mile from the platform at Dawlish. So we'll apply the brakes just as we're entering the tunnel to step 3. Now you can see the platforms at Dawlish just ahead of us. Just reducing the brakes to step 2 as we've slowed down just a little bit too much. Though 25 miles per hour entering the platform is a pretty good speed. The stopping point for an HST is actually just beyond the end of the platform here. You see a marker that says HST 2 plus 7 car. And slightly beyond that is an HST 2 plus 8 car for the 8 coach train. So we're a 7 coach train today, we'll be stopping at the first stop marker. So just as the stop marker disappears is the perfect place to stop. Now we have the all clear to depart Dawlish. We're now running fast to Exeter. This is actually the longest and most difficult section for me to memorise for the speed limits. So do remember that the speed limit departing is 60 miles per hour, though as you can see in front of us, the speed limit's about to go up to 75 miles per hour. However, there will be again a speed reduction back to 70, and we'll reach that before we've actually achieved 70 miles per hour. See, we've now entered the 70 mile per hour speed zone, so once the speedometer is reading 70, we will shut off power and coast to the next speed limit, which is an increase to 80 miles per hour. Now reach 70, so the power's shut off, and there's the 80 board. Be sure that the back of the train has cleared the 80 board as this line on the right diverges. Now the line on the right's diverged, we can apply full power to accelerate to 80 miles per hour until the next speed limit, which is a reduction down to 75. Reached 80 miles per hour, so we'll shut off power and coast, and as we pass this signal we're now a mile away from the 75 mile per hour speed limit. As we pass this Morpeth board, we're half a mile from the speed limit. Just apply step one braking to ensure that we're slowed down to 75. Now release the brakes and coast. Passing through Starcross. As the speed is slowly reducing towards 70 miles per hour, we'll now apply step one power. This will increase the speed again slightly, and once we are back at 75, we'll once again shut off power and continue coasting. Thank you. as we round this sharp curve to the left, we've gone back to step one power, and just as we leave this curve you'll see a speed board for the speed limit of 100 miles per hour, which is the fastest speed limit on this journey. As we're already doing below 75, we'll apply full power as soon as we pass the board. If we were actually on the 75 speed limit, we'd wait until the crossing we just went over before applying full power. Now as we reach 100 miles per hour, now shut off power, we'll coast temporarily until the speed drops to around 97 or 98, and then we'll reapply power to step one. Now back up to step one power. Shouldn't need to do anything with the power now until our next speed reduction, which is to 75 miles per hour. Speed limit, shut off power and apply braking to step 3. The Morpeth board is actually 3/4 of a mile from the speed limit itself. Now releasing the brakes on the speed limit and applying one step of power to ensure I don't lose too much speed. The next speed reduction is to 45 miles per hour, which is just before Exeter St. David's. We now have the speed warning for the 45. We'll apply step 2 braking. Again, the Morpeth board is 3/4 of a mile from the speed limit itself. Now receiving a double yellow signal aspect because we're approaching Exeter St. David's, and the signal at the other end of the platform is set to red. The brakes at 45 miles per hour, and as we pass the board we're now just 1/2 mile from the station. We're on this bridge now, crossing the River Ex. We will again go into step 2 braking. Now up to step 3. Slightly misjudged that, had to go up to step 4 to ensure that we're losing enough speed. There's no exact stopping point for the HST here, so I use the sign on the right that says Classic Selection, Great British Trains. Once you reach the end of that, that's roughly the stopping point. Reduce the brakes slightly to try and give a smoother stop. That stop was unfortunately slightly harder than I planned. Here we are, arrival at Exeter St. David's.